Let's just check our overview right here. Timetables. Yep, it's going good. Right, everything is going nice right now. We're probably going to need to create some more power, and we have got plenty of iron, so I'm actually going to go ahead and create some new solar panels right here. Ugh, I really want to get rid of these bloody things. Can I mine them? Let's see if I can mine that out. Right, the guy is doing good over here. Kid is planting new beautiful flowers in our rooms so that everyone can be happy times. What temperature is it outside? It's 11 outside. It's pretty warm in here. I think we'll leave the... are these vents even working properly? The vents don't seem to be working especially well, right? Because it's 20 in here, and in the corridor it's 13, so it's dropping 7 degrees going through that vent. 15, 23... 14. It's dropping a lot of temperature, you know. Right, it's 1 degree in our new refrigeration room, so let's create a new zone, right? A new stockpile zone through here. And we're going to copy our storage settings, and then we're going to paste it in here. And then we're going to set... this one right now is set as preferred, so we will set this one up as important. So they'll start transferring the food across to this section right here. Where's the rename zone? Ah, here we go. So we'll call this main refrigeration. I should have renamed these ages ago. Freezer, and then these are all fine. These are just fine as normal stockpiles. And look, we've got a lot of stuff on this section already. We've finished our antimatter reactor. Great. Okay, let's antimatter propulsion. We'll start on this. How we're going to create that stuff, I don't even know, though. We're going to need loads of weird materials, which we have never found so far, but we might be able to buy them if we sell and trade. Right, we're going to start working on some rooms and stuff soon as well. Do you know what we need to build? We need to build bloody hydroponics. Why we never did this. Oh yeah, that's why I didn't do it, because... yeah, we didn't build more hydroponics because the stupid map barrier interfered with my plan, but I'm going to build some more there anyway. Let's get the... actually, we don't need to create a door for hydroponics. It's absolutely fine. I don't know what this room was going to be here, this space. Oh, I think it was just... I think there was just steel there. I think that's all that was. Let's just make a new door, like here. And then let's create a new wall. Right here. So then we'll make that into a new space, new room. Okay, we're doing really good with tree cutting. We've got plenty of wood now, so that's great. This new area here, where we need to haul this crap out of here. Let's get this out of here. Get all that stuff out. Oh, we're open to the world. Let's get a door in here real quick. Floor down. Get a wood floor. Great. Okay. It's all going in the right direction, guys. We can still create another bedroom in here as well, so let's do that. 6x6. Like we do. And we need to create a door on these rooms. Let's make a wood door right there. We're going to need to mine through so we can regulate temperature on this room as well. So we'll do that. Actually, you know what? Yeah, actually that's fine, because then I can put a heater in that room and it will distribute through for everyone. So we'll do that. Actually, let's do that now as well. Put a temperature, put a heater in here. It's plenty warmer right now, actually, so we can turn off our heaters. Save ourselves some power. Frog, would you mind doing that? Good job. Right, going well here. And we've got our first turret up and running over here. That's excellent. Well, this one's already working. Engie, where are you going? Are you... Oh, she's Engie's building the turret for us. Look at this. Great. Good job, Engie. We have struck compacted steel. Okay, let's go look. Wow, okay, we've got some steel down here. Pablo. God, how pleased are you that we didn't lose Pablo? I was actually semi-traumatized at the thought of losing Pablo. That would have just been absolutely terrible. We need to make a new vent. We'll get one in here. There we go. Right, things are going well. I think they are anyway. We've made a lot of progress. Oh yeah, we need to just move those medicines. Yeah, see, look, as soon as we have our new refrigeration area, suddenly our food stockpile starts to look a little sparse, am I right? Starting to look a little dodgy. I think I want to create a proper prison holding facility, right? And then this whole room here, we can kind of delete the refrigeration area, and this can be like our sort of reception room here, and then we can put like a leisure room and stuff up here. So I think this is what we're going to do. In fact, actually, I think the prisoner's room can really be along this here, or maybe this area right here. This would work good. We could maybe do it up here. So let's work on that, actually. Let's just plan that real quick. So we'll put like a cell block right here. We'll keep Gabella. She can have her room because she's been living here for so long. I don't think I want to have them have huge rooms because they don't, you know, they're prisoners, so who cares. Give them some 4x4 rooms. That should be more than adequate. A little generous, in fact. Oh, look, and it even works perfectly space-wise, so this is absolutely designed to be. We need to have a corridor run along here. So it's going to be like that. And it needs to have also exterior access so they can get in and out real quick. Let's just see then. So, oh yeah, the only trouble with that though is it actually needs to go down there because we obviously need to create doors and we can't do that if we do it how I was just setting it out. So it needs to be more like this basically. Da, 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 da. And then with that said, I mean, I don't know if we're going to need more than three right here, but if we did have more than three prisoners, we'd need to create like... Let's stagger the doors, right, for a start, because we don't want them chatting to each other across the doors. So we'll put another one like that, and another one like that, and another one there. Because the corridor's going to go like this, and like this. And then they'd have to have a room like 1, 2, 3, 4, and then here, 1, 2, 3, 4, and here, 1, 2, 3, 4. And then we'd need to create a wall along here, like so. It's actually going to work pretty good, so I think we'll definitely do that. Let's start off by creating the exterior wall in a minute. We need to mine out some areas here, right? So we're going to have to mine basically through there. And then we need to mine out these rooms like this. And then we also need to mine between them because I want to get some vent access going through there so we can regulate temperature. And then, yeah, I think that's all I need to do for now. We might install, yeah, we'll put like a, because it gets, I don't think it's ever going to get too warm actually, so I don't think we need to cool it down. Okay, that's good. It's looking good. Okay, so that's perfect. Let's just haul this crap out of here. Okay, things are looking up for us, guys. It's going nicely right now. Real nice. Okay, what is this area right here? Is this my, like, I don't even know what this is for. Items and weapons. Okay, so that's obviously for my like pickup zone. It's for this basically. That's what it's for. But this stuff is outside the area. I think you can actually yeah, so around the orbital trade beacon you can actually create a stockpile. So I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to move the orbital trade beacon like down into here, and then we'll move some of this stockpile stuff out of the way. So again, we're going to utilize this space a little differently. Jesus, man, look at my other stockpile here. We really need to somebody needs to start making some stone blocks, or we need to actually get metal from that slag.
You slag.
Luton, I know it's early days, but would you recommend the new 40k? It's looking really nice. I'm having a good chat with the devs. They're very happy and positive about their game. But I would say, you know, just wait a little longer. You know, you don't need to jump in right at this stage. You can wait a bit more. So I would suggest to do that. Right, the guys are doing a grand job here of mining up for us. How are you guys in the live stream enjoying today, the Rimworld? I was really pleased that we actually came in to do this, because I wasn't sure. I really did want to do Skylands tonight, but I'm actually very pleased we did Rimworld, because I have enjoyed this greatly, and it sort of spurred me to maybe make some more of this game, because I really do love this game. Right, we are going to need to continue mining out this area as well. Something occurs to me, though, is that if I build this wall up here, it's going to create another... Let me just check my no roof regions. Yeah, so basically I need to make this whole bloody area a no roof region. So we're just going to do this to be on the safe side, right? Because the last thing I want is to have some bloody stupid roof thing happening for us. Okay, that should protect us for now. Will I post this all on Luton Gaming? Yeah, of course, definitely. It definitely will go on there. I'm actually just checking I'm not dropping any frames, because that can sometimes happen over time, but it's actually fine. None of you guys were complaining anyway. Haul stuff here. Right, let's just haul a little bit more of this. This is all going very nicely. Okay, now we have completed this. Now I need to basically... I'm going to shut this down. So that's shut down. We can actually deconstruct that refrigeration unit, we can deconstruct that door, and it's a shame we can't deconstruct floors, like the wooden floors. It'd be nice if you could just gather them up and have like wooden floor tiles and stick them down somewhere else. Are you really enjoying it? Oh, yeah, actually I should just, right now guys, I'm just going to post here in the stream. Right, okay. So basically we'll expand this room up here as we go. We'll keep the fridge at the freezer as it is where it is. Where's our brewery as well, actually? Can't we even build a brewery right now? I think we can, right? We must have machining table. Where is it? Where's our brewery? Oh, here it is, brewery. Yeah, we never built a brewery, but we bloody should. So that'll be one of our things to build, I think. We've still got our compacted steel down here. The guys seem to have prioritised building the prison, but that's fine with me as well. We do actually need to mine out this silver, so that'll be like a little extra thing. We'll have to fix that later. The guys really need to sort of... we need to get someone prioritising on creating these blocks and stuff. But I'm sure they'll do that. Is it getting... Oh, it's just foggy. It's not actually cold. Right, defences are actually looking okay as well, but we do need to get like a little sort of backup defence happening right here, so I'm going to just build that. Yep, that should be fine. So this will just be a little backup defence line that we can have. God, it's gotten real dark. It gets dark so quick. Come on, Gabella. You've been here for like 2 years, dude. You should want to join us by now. This is one thing I wanted to get him to fix up. See you next time, Aftershock. This is one First General says, first time I caught you streaming Rimworld, and I'm impressed. It's rare to see a colony I wouldn't mind living in. I know, right? But I try to always think of how nice I would like it to be. But the other colony, like I keep saying, oh, we've got a great sculpture. Okay, she's finished another sculpture for us. That's great. I just enjoy the designing of the colony as well. It's really nice. That's a great feature. You can actually, you know, adjust the difficulty so much, and you can make it so that you can create a real nice colony. Who's buried out the back here? This was somebody... Who's in here, man? I can't remember who it was who we buried out the back here. I think it was some... It was either... I can't remember. I'm sure it was someone important. We still haven't finished that extra solar panel. Right, our storage pile is completely full, which is not great. We need to really rethink that. And our stone brick area is... I think we need to adjust our zonages right here. I'm going to create this one like this. Are you idiot, Lutin? I've got to create a whole new one. Right, let's go here. We need to make it as... Yeah, none of that. No corpses. No rotten. No body parts. No apparel. No weapons. No items. Raw resources, stone blocks, manufactured, no. So we don't want manufactured, we don't want foods. What we want to have is only stone blocks, no gold. Right, here we are. We just want stone blocks, that's all we want. And we're going to put that as preferred. Okay, great, okay. Right. Bernard. Taking them back to stockpile one, which is not what we want. Right, let's take this stockpile right here and expand it a little. We have got so much stuff to store here, it's ridiculous. I'm going to create another layer up the top as well. So that's going to give us quite a lot more. Okay, there we go. We really need to get somebody on the things in terms of creating new stone bricks though. Prem, I'm amazed you've remembered this. Prem says the grave on the back side here was one of my own. He died in the big raider attack. He was throwing grenades like a boss. I don't remember who it was. I really want to look back and find out now. NG, good girl. She's chopping down those old buildings. Temperature's rising in the main refrigeration, 4 degrees. It's because it's so warm outside, it's like 20 outside. Let's drop the temperature down. And that should regulate. Damn, it's 6 degrees inside. It needs to go down a lot more than that. Yeah, it's getting there now. Sometimes with the temperature, you obviously have to kind of adjust it a little bit more. It still needed to go down more, though. Yeah, it's about 2 degrees now. That's okay. There's a combat supplier passing. I might just... Candice, can you speak to the combat recruits? What have they got? They've got some artillery shells for sale. They're selling artillery shells cheap, actually. 32. I think it's we got plenty of money for that. I think we'll just buy the lot. Yeah. Incendiary launcher. Oh, we might just get rid of the bow. We don't need it, do we? Let's just create extra space. Peeler. Not going to use that. Get rid of that. Steel knife. Get rid of that. Okay. Medicine. We've got enough medicine. Got an armoured vest for 10 grand. No, that's golden military helmet. I think I got an armoured vest for 319. Do you know what? I'm going to take that as well. As we... Okay, great. We've got some good stuff now. Okay, so we've got some good artillery. We'll make that back easy as well when we sell this sculpture. So... Do British use Celsius for temperature? Yeah, we definitely do. I want to deconstruct that whole area right there. Right, things are going well here. Right, we need to create a new section for this. We need to create, because this is going to be my sort of delivery area for selling. But where the hell we're going to create that, I don't know. Yeah, we need a new storage area for like wood, plastic, steel, and all this stuff. Where we're going to do that, I don't know. Okay, we can create some more flooring in here. Get new wood floors, all new wood floors in. We need to get some doors in as well, get the doors in. They're creating the vents for us, which is good. Oh yeah, we actually need to mine in here and create a new vent through there as well. Structure, let's create some beds and stuff. So we're going to need a wooden... Oh, do we not have enough wood? Yeah, we do. We have enough wood. Get the bed in there. I'm not going to build lights and stuff in there until somebody needs to be in there anyway. Right, good. Things are going nice. We made some big progress today. Right, and the prison cells are coming on okay. Let's get the things set up right for that. So we're going to get vents, and then we're going to need doors for these guys. Simon failed to recruit Gabella. What a surprise right there. Oh yeah, we just need to create a little wall right here. Okay, going well. Right, we'll just put them wooden floors in here. And we also need to create some limestone walls through this section here. That needs to go like that. And then we're good, I think. And we'll actually, how are we actually doing on limestone here? Yeah, we're doing okay. Still got to create this whole bloody wall out here, though, which hasn't really happened. That needs to be a priority, really. Oh, cool. NG's actually creating our hydroponics. Good for her. Brilliant. Okay, cool. We're still going to need more power. We'll get NG to look at that later. Our rice crop is coming on pretty good. Rice is actually real good to grow in hydroponics, actually, as well, so I'll probably set that. Because it grows real fast when it's just got that, like, 24-hour power to it. Oh, I'm just wondering whether I've actually got the... Do you know what? We don't need a standing lamp in here. What we need is a sun lamp. I don't even know why we had that. What we need to get is production. What is it under though? I forget. I think it's under miscellaneous maybe? Yeah, sun lamp. Look, this is what we need in here. The bloody sun lamp. Right, come on, come on, hurry up, kid. Kid is just getting the materials to build our sun lamp. Basically, that's my own stupidity. Kid, are you going to actually build this, dude? No, because you probably can't. Pablo, can you fix that? Oh, he's already doing it. Okay, great. The sun lamp, basically, there you go. See, let's look at the much better light that's giving off for us. Cargo pods, great. Where are they? Right, it's got some meat for us. Human meat, Jesus. Where is that as well? That's miles away. Do you know, I might leave it, to be fair. I'm not really sure I want to eat that. I think we'll leave it be, if I'm honest. I don't think we want to be eating human meat. Obviously someone got badly shredded on the way down. I mean, look, anyway, our farm is coming on excellently. We don't need any more meat. Although we do need some stuff in there, that's for sure. Here, rain. This is going to help our potatoes and corn. Corn is nearly ready for harvesting, actually. Oh yeah, Frog, we need to get another vent in there, dude. There we go. Right, wonderful. I'll tell you what we do need as well. We need more beds right here. Where's the... We can actually build cryosleep caskets. We don't have any uranium, though. Where's the med bed? Oh, we've got the ship cryosleep casket. Ship structural beam. We can actually build this. Ship computer core we need. And we've got enough for a ship reactor. I'm not actually entirely sure how to build a ship, though, because I've never had to do it, so... But we can probably plan to do it. We've actually got good space up here, so this is where we can build our ship to escape. Oh good, the guys are constructing our wall now, which is fantastic news. We should be able to have some berries nearby we can harvest or something right now. Oh yeah, here we are, look, there's always berries out the back here. Let's harvest this. Yeah, it's saying we're low on food, but we're not. We've got plenty of stuff. This corn is going to be ready in a day or so. We'll be just fine. Okay, the new prisons are pretty much ready. We just need to get some beds in there. We better get power going on here. So we've got our power going through there for the prison. Gonna need to get some steel doors in there. Well, the guys are not doing too bad of a job of constructing, but we need more bricks. We're running really low on bricks now, and it's because we have not been building enough. Candice, aren't you like the brick cutting person? I'm pretty sure Candice was like my official stone cutter for a while, right? Because it's under construction. Candice, you know, what's her main thing? Art. Oh yeah, she's good at art, good at research. I'm going to take research off. I'm going to put construct. I think that's the main thing for like stone cutting and stuff, right? Jay is the guy that got buried. Okay, there we go, we find out. Hey, Candice, what's the bloody... I told you, prioritise stone cutting. We need stone. I wish you could just tell someone to prioritise something. They do it until you want them to stop, basically. Right, we have now researched nearly everything we need. Where's Candice off to? Where are you going? Hauling wood. I'm not sure whether construct is the right thing for like stone cutting and stuff. Oh crap, here we go, raid. They're attacking immediately. Oh bugger me. This was what I was very worried about. Hopefully my gun turret though will do enough. Bernard, what are you up to? Okay, he's going to bed. Right, okay, I've got a plan here. Where is Huntsman? Here he is. Right, we'll just position them at the doors. NG, wake up. Right, my turret is still in the mix. So basically the plan here is that NG, she's got the shotgun. Actually, NG, just come here. So there we go. Candice, where the frickin' hell are you going? You're going to bed, okay. There They've got to break through this door. I'm just letting the turret do everything it can. It's that the turret's actually doing a bang-up job. Friendlies, a group of friendly outlanders from Dreams That Were Right, they're moving in to help you immediately. Oh, beautiful. So now we're getting actually some help from some friendlies. Where are they, though? They're probably miles away, right? Yeah, here they are. They're quite far away. I doubt they're going to get here in time. My little turret here is doing a good job. If we actually have just an extra turret on this back end. There we are. One of them's down. Right, let's just get another set of forced target on this guy right here. Come on, come on, come on. I mean, one, what if we get... Oh, actually, screw that. Actually, let's get a forced target on this guy right here, because this guy's got a sniper rifle. Come on, turret. You're doing great. Come on, turret. Yes. If we can take this guy down, we're going to get a bloody sniper rifle. The body, I think, is actually absorbing some of the bullets and stuff. Come on, take him down. Take him down. Get a sniper rifle for us. Come on. And we'll have Huntsman with a sniper rifle. Come on. Get him. Come on, one more, one more. He's got to be low on health now. Come on, get him. This guy's dead. Oh, come on, turret. Just survive a little longer. Come on. Oh, so every time I think it's going to go down. I reckon if we get this guy, we're done. That's it. Yes. And he died as well. Now we've got a bloody sniper rifle. How about that? Nice. Okay. What's Pablo's shooting skill? Is he good or not? A6. He's not bad. Get Pablo to equip this survival rifle. Huntsman, congrats. You are upgraded to a sniper rifle, dude. Nicely played. That's right. Tooled up. Right, go back. Pablo's having a meal, because why the hell not? Yak, right here. Yak is like, Yak's got it going on like Humongous Star from Mad Max 2, look. He's just like naked, but he's got a body shield on. Okay, right, we'll strip these guys down in a minute. Good times. Well, that was yet another successful defense of the base. But I tell you what we do need to do. We need to build another bloody turret around the back here, seriously. Probably going to build like another little one right here, actually. We'll get some sandbags, look. Like that. Yeah, that went surprisingly well. Actually, you know what? We're going to not have that there. I'm going to put one up here. Like this. We'll put them a little way away from each other so they don't blow up on each other, actually. In fact, actually, I'm still editing this. Let's get it like... a bit more like that. I'm going to put another one in between. That's a block. Yeah, look, so we have two there. And then we can just get another one here. We're going to need some power to run over to that, though. It's a pain, because I don't really want to run... I really don't want to run a power cable through Candice's room, because they hate that. So I will actually take the trouble to run a power conduit outside. That should be good enough. Pablo is wrapping up our thing. Got a simple meal here as well. Wonderbar. Okay, well that was actually really good. Really, really good. Yeah, that turret is really OP. Like, it did a... it's a plasteel improved turret. You know why that turret's so good? It's because it's a plasteel turret, not a standard turret. Actually, let's get that one off here. Let's build, because you can build different kinds of turret. You see, so that you can choose what to build your turret out of. You build the turret out of plasteel, it's a way better turret. Which is probably what I should do with all of these. These ones as well are plasteel turrets, you see. And so they will actually survive much longer. They don't take such a kicking. The ones we've got up at the back here are just standard steel turrets, basically. Anyway, good stuff. Excuse me. Right, everyone else is building on here. We still need more bloody bricks. What is it? What is it to build bricks? Is it like construct, or is it... It's not going to be repair, it should be construct. Or is it mine? I don't know. Craft. It is stone cutting, it's craft, that's what we want. So I'm going to take Candice off of construction. She can still do it, obviously. We're going to put her as a crafter, number one. Who else is real good at crafting, though? Yeah, look, Engie is brilliant at crafting. Trouble is, Engie is so good at everything. Engie is, like, probably the most valuable person in the colony right now. Right, let's just see who else is good at crafting. Maybe somebody's caught me out here. 4, 4, 4. Nobody, nobody is good. Actually, I say that Pablo is actually pretty good at crafting, and he's... Yeah, but we'll put Pablo as the crafter right now. He needs a holiday for crafting. Where are you, Pablo? He's repping stuff. Well, you're going to change that up, dude. You're going to go do this instead. Right, we do need to bury these guys in the ground, so I'm going to get Brexios to do that. Can you strip that guy? And this guy. And these guys have got some nice gear as well. This would be great for us. Okay, there we go. Right, we're getting buried in the ground as quick as possible. I don't really need to worry about telling them who's going to wear what. Actually, what's that thing right there? Armor vest poor. Armor vest normal. Okay, fine. Right, excellent. Excellent. So Pablo, we hope, is going to be... Pablo's still wrapping up. That's fine. Okay, Pablo, you do that. Who else is actually repping? It's pretty much only Pablo and Engie. Probably should set some other people. Look, Yak, a digger. I'll put him on repair as well. Kid, you could be repping as well. So could Bernard as well. There's a lot of people that are pretty decent at repping. Huntsman. And repping isn't something that needs to happen that often. So if I put them as a one on it, it's probably not going to interfere with too many other things. And that rice is looking real good for harvest, 72%. This corn here is at 90%. I'm actually going to harvest some of this corn here because we are getting a little low on food, and we'll have plenty of other food come in real soon, so I don't think it's a big problem for us to harvest a little bit of that corn just to eat, just to tide us over. In fact, actually, we've kind of run out of food, actually, so who is our plant cutter? It's Brexios. Oh, he's already doing it. Look, he's already doing it. He's doing just what he needs to. And now we've got beautiful corn to eat. Huntsman's going to go in there and do that. Oh, we actually did make simple meals. I'm impressed. I'm going to add a bill for a fine meal. Right, things are going very, very well. We've nearly finished completing our prison. We can transfer some of the prisoners up there, and then we can start constructing our sort of fine eating area and stuff. The wall is nearly completed as well. This is great news. Cargo pods have just landed. Oh, we got some food, and it's real close to the base for once. Great. Okay, let's get all that. We've got some finest boom rat meat. Beautiful. Beautiful. And we've got some finally some blocks, so hopefully Pablo's going to be blocking it on the next one. Right, everything is going great. Look at this. So good. So good. I think I'm actually going to change it up as well. Pablo deserves a brand new bedroom. I'm going to give him this one down here. He deserves it. Temperature indoors is 5. Oh crap, we're facing starvation, it says, but Engie is facing starvation. Well, she won't be pretty soon because she's eating right now. There we go. Beautiful. Okay. It's raining. Oh, I see what's happening right here. We actually need to get... We'll do that. That should hopefully give enough power through there. Candice has gone back to doing what she does best, which is creating beautiful tools. Pablo, look at him working away solidly. Do you know what we need to do right here? Do you know what we need to do? We need to make Pablo have his own little... his own little work area, because look at this, it's a disgrace. He's having to work in the rain. This is a nonsense. He needs his own little workstation here, look. Let's actually get rid of some of this corn off of here, look. get rid of that corn, look, we're going to build like a little workstation here for Pablo. Kind of insane. Working in the rain, poor man. Just have wooden doors, we don't need to go mental. There we go. Look, that's much better, right? We get some wooden floor in here as well. Perfect. If he's lucky, we'll even get a lamp in there, you know? In fact, we definitely need to do that. But we also need to, excuse my voice. We also need to add this. We need to remove the no roof region on this building. Because otherwise, we won't actually make a roof. Right, there we go. We're not knocking down the corn, we're harvesting the corn. That's what it's for. Right, these guys will build this stuff, so we don't need to worry. How are we doing on power? We're doing good, the batteries are all up and running. In fact, actually, we have the opportunity to make more batteries, really. I'm probably going to create a new battery area here, so let's actually extend the wall like this. And actually, before we even do that, we need to mine it out, so let's cancel that. We need to mine this area out. But with that said, I'm not going to cancel off of there. I'm going to wait until it stops raining before I mine into where the batteries are, because I don't want them to just short circuit all over the place. Bernard's got some new threads. Check it out. Like, everyone is building Pablo's shelter, which is great. We need to get that bloody wall finished. Our Engie, she's working night and day. She's working 9 to 5. Look at this. Good job, Engie. Exotic goods trader. Beautiful. Let's sell that sculpture and make some money back. We've finished researching coloured lights. Okay, we have researched everything now. So Frog is going to need to have something else to do. So let's see what Frog is going to do now. Frog, what are you going to do now that you're not a researcher? Mining? No. Art, maybe. Crafting, no. No, this is the trouble with Frog, he's crap at everything, basically. Melee, you're okay at. Growing, you're good at. Okay, grow, that's what you're going to do. You're going to grow and look after crops. You can also repair. You can kind of construct. Can't haul. Can't clean. Can't plant cut. So I guess you're a grower and a constructor and a repairer. That's what you're going to do, Frog. You're going to do all those things. I wonder if we can actually deconstruct the repair station right now as well. Right, so we've done everything there is to do. Candy, so I'm going to have you stop doing that. I want you to create these blueprints for me, please. There we go, and now the heater is functioning. Get some nice warmth in here. Make things a little bit better. Simon ends up sleeping in the... Whoa! And that was what I was concerned about. Oh! See, I knew. This is why we needed to get this covered up. Electric smelter has short-circuited in the rain and started a fire. See, this is why we needed to get that put out. Yak, can you please go and deal with that? This is why we're building a shelter here in the first place. Whilst you're here, dude, get this working on. Right, the sooner we get this building covered up, the better. Come on, guys. Get these doors done. Still haven't constructed that as well. Oh, look at this. We have nearly completed the wall. Beautiful. This is really good. And we're nearly running out of food, but our rice is back. Okay, there we are. Look, beautiful. We have now got it enclosed. This is really, really, really good. Simon failed to recruit again. Surprise. Right, let's look at what we're going to do next. So the next thing to do is probably going to be to set up over here. So let's get some power and lights and stuff happening. Furniture, standing lamp. So we've got the standing lamps in here for these guys. Temperature is just fine. They don't need anything else. So this is going to be prisoner beds. So basically what's going to happen is I will set this to a colonist. And then someone will automatically move her dinner up to the new prison block area. Similarly, Vasilo, we'll just set that to a normal section right there. We'll expand Simon's room in here so he has a better room. Frog, where are you off to? Resting, okay. Where are you going, Simon? Clearing rock rubble. Hey, it actually worked. We actually managed to mine out that collapsed space. I like how Simon walked all the way around there to just like sweep up the rock a little bit. Anyway, we are low on food right now, but as you can see, our rice plants are at 96% and our potato plants are at 95%. So we are bang on ready for doing that. We are going to need to start harvesting and growing some new areas up here, but that's exactly what this is for. So let's clear up what's left of this space. And let's also chop wood from anything left in this space. And let's cut plants as well from anywhere. Actually, we don't need to really cut plants. But what we can do, we'll start farming properly. So let's do that. So we need to zone. We're going to stockpile, actually, growing zone rather. Let's actually just go from out here. Like, we'll just do this. Big growing zone. So we're going to grow in this one. Let's grow... we'll grow some more potatoes, maybe. Or rice. Grow some more potatoes up in that section. Raid. They're attacking immediately. Oh, Jesus. They've landed actually in our base. That's not good. Let's see what they got going on. Sugar. Oh, they're going outside. But that's not good either, because our turrets and stuff don't actually have... Oh, bugger. Okay, this is bad. Actually, alright, frog, alright. Just grab... Right, this is the true testing one, guys. This is going to be what it's all about. Right, Huntsman, I want you to come over here. Bernard can back you up. Pablo, you're going to come around here. Frog is going to stand guard inside. Engie's going to come with Pablo. Simon, what have you got going on? Pistol as well. You just come down here. Candice has got a knife. She can just stay where she is. Brexios can also come up here. So can Yak. Right, let's defend our home, guys. These idiots, for some reason, are going outside. Right, Huntsman getting a bloody mix, man. Why can't he aim at them? Not that line of sight. Why can't he fire it? I don't understand. Does he have any ammo for this gun or something? What's up with this? Why can't Huntsman fire, guys? I'm really confused. I don't really care if they destroy this crap out here right now. Unfortunately, our turrets were off. Drop the shield, is that what it is? Okay. Oh yeah, that is what it... Thank you, guys. Right, here we go. Pablo's got the same deal going on. They must have picked it up, and because I don't remember equipping them with it. Let's get in the mix. The guys are doing a good job of defending right now. He's going to take hits from everybody right here. Come on, come on, come on, Bernard, stop him. Yeah, got him in the mix. Okay, Beatrice has got a bloody sniper rifle. I'm going to move Bernard up here. Oh, actually, she's already... Down she goes. Brilliant. Dead. A successful defense, guys. A successful defense. And not a single person even took a hit. Brilliant. 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 We did excellently there. Really, really well done. Good job, everybody. Everybody did a good job. Excellent. Excellent work. Okay, great. Let's mop up and repair and all the rest of it. Great. That was so good. And we've got loads of fantastic materials now as well. Is excellent, excellent, excellent. Oh, Dixon apparently is still alive. Great, we'll capture him. A mad animal. It's a squirrel. And where is it? It's actually pretty near. That's fine. I'm actually going to get Pablo to... Actually, we'll worry about that later. I was going to turn the turrets back on, but we'll do it in a little bit. Yeah, they did get wrecked. Part of their failure was definitely in going out, and that was a bit of a silly mistake for them to make. Our huntsman is praying, bless his heart. Brexios, can you just strip Beatrice there? Great, good job. Look at all the guns we've got now. We are kitted. Come on, stop that mad squirrel. Good job. Okay. Now we need to build some more graves. The grave situation is looking kind of hilarious now. This is all the people we've killed. Oh, look, the wall is pretty much complete now, guys. This is beautiful. I'm wondering or not whether we maybe need to just put like a couple of internal turrets here just to be on the safe side next time, you know? Might consider doing that. We've got the resources. It's going to be power that's the factor, though. I mean, we still need to finish this. NG, I want you to finish working on that solar generator. We need to get some more... Oh, yeah, we need to finish building our battery section here as well. So let's do that. And we're going to mine this out right here. Let me just do that. Orders, mine. Mine that. We'll put some more batteries in there, basically. Bernard is burying our good friend here. Oh, what's he doing? Bernard, where are you going with him? Are you just storing him? Oh, okay. We can create, a crematorium, so we could actually build that as well. Turrets are wrapped up and good. We've got nice plasteel turrets here. A roof has collapsed. Where? Nobody got injured. Still didn't finish up the sandbag blueprint right down here. Oh yeah, we were going to also build like another security turret down here as well, like right here. Yeah, we'll get a couple. So we've got a couple on the back. We've got good stuff on the front. I'm very tempted to put like another plasteel turret in this front section here, just so we've got like an extra backup. Just get like another one in there, so we've got like double the power. I mean, we've got like all these materials all over the place. I thought they'd have been storing them away. Okay, right, let's get some extra batteries in here now. So power, battery. So we'll just get those extra batteries in there. And then what I want to create is like a power switch on here. So I'm going to deconstruct this power conduit here. And I'm going to put a switch in there. Kid, can you just... Yeah, do that. Okay, and then I'm going to put in a power switch on this point. Actually, why is it not letting me do that? Why? Space already occupied. It's probably because this door is here. Brexios has got a pretty crappy room, so we might sort of look at fixing that up. Did NG finish? I told you, NG, to finish that bloody solar power plant, and she hasn't done it. Anyway, so the reason we've done that is that, as I say, I want to disconnect that power from the grid so that we can save it for when we really need it. Brexios is essentially sleeping outside tonight, but luckily it's not too cold. Let's make sure how we're doing on the food front. Simple meals. Do you know what we should actually do this is... we'll just do that. And we'll just have it at 60. Hey, I thought it was this one collapsed again. I'm just going to have to leave those bloody collapsed rocks there, because they will not have it. They just keep re-collapsing all the time. Right, let's get a new door in here as well. We need to get another steel door. Oh yeah, crap. Dixon probably does need a little bit of medicine. Yeah, he's in quite a bad way, but what I will do is... See, in the updated version of RimWorld... Hey, what happened to our harvest? This should have all been harvested by now. Yeah, it's ready to harvest. Hold on a sec, let me just tell them to harvest right here. And all these potatoes should be good to go as well. Anyway... So yeah, in this version of RimWorld, you can only select whether a prisoner gets medicine or not, and that's it. But on the updated version, you can choose whether they get certain types of medicine. So you can select that they only receive like herbal medicine. It means that you can save the better medicine for your own colonists, and the doctors won't actually end up treating prisoners with crazy stuff. Got visitors, Jeweler's Township are welcome always. NG's digging some graves here. It's the same alone food, but we should have plenty of food, seriously. Right, let's finish silver wall. No, limestone wall. Let me tell you, we haven't built a silver wall anywhere, please. That would be insane. We bloody have. Oh my god, idiots. Oh, I'm gonna have to deconstruct that. Who built a silver wall? Holy crap. Yeah, deconstruct, please. The silver wall. How ridiculous. Right, anyway, so the batteries are back up on the grid, and what we'll do is we'll just let that fill up, and then once it's filled up, I'll just disconnect it from the grid. Okay, I'm just thinking here. Everything seems to be going pretty good. I was thinking one thing though, which is that we should really upgrade this door here. So we should put like plasteel doors because they're way stronger. And we have actually got a lot of plasteel. So we should probably upgrade the main entry-exit doors to the colony as plasteel rather than just standard steel. Similarly like this one right here. Although, I mean, most of the time it's not going to be a big concern for us. But Right, I'm going to actually add in another turret here. We'll just have a standard steel turret. Because we don't want to get caught with our pants down if they attack us yet again. Anyway, so our kill zone here is looking nice. There's another great thing in the updated version, like the next version, you can create like traps. So what you could do right here is put like a trap so that when they come through, it like lands on them, and you can, you know, that's really good as well. It's a good, it's another good defense tool, basically. Right, so we're gonna have four turrets there. And what I will do is I will basically put a switch on here. We turn that on and off, so that way they're not using power all the time. So I put a power switch on that point there, and then that way I can just turn it on and off, which will help us save power for the batteries and stuff. Oh, we finally built the extra solar power plant. Wonderful. We're going to continue building stuff actually, though. So let's get another solar plant out here. We're doing good on the, look at Pablo, he's working away like a boss, like he has done ever since we landed here. He's just soldiering through, just cracking through it. Doesn't complain. Look at him go, man, he's just burning through it. He doesn't mess around at all. Right, let's get an extra limestone wall in there, finish that up. Okay, this is good.